स्वेच्छाकेसरिणः स्वच्छस्वच्छाय आयासित इन्दवः त्रायन्ताम्बो मुदुरिपोः प्रपन्नार्तिच्छिदो नखाः अतो ह्यन्यतमेनापि प्रकारेण विभूषित वाणी नवत्वमायाति पूर्वार्थ अन्वयवत्यपि फ्रम् दिस् कारिका वि लुक्ड् एट् अ कपल् आफ् एक्साम्पल्स् सो ईवन् The even if the Saraswati, which is you know navatvam ayati, she na Saraswati is speech here, vani artha purva artha anvayavatyapi, even if she follows the meaning that is there, which has been described by many other earlier poets, even if it follows the same meaning, it still has something or the other which is beautiful and new. So the newer aspect that the poet has introduced into that same idea can actually make it a better shlokam also. See, he has been giving some of the examples for that. Savibhrama smitodbedaha lolakshyaha, instead of that we saw how smitam kinchin mugdham taralamadhuro drishti vibhavaha, and then yav pratamaha pratamaha and svatejak krita mahima. We saw two examples for that. Now we'll move on to the third one. I will explain the second shloka first. So here, shunyam vasagriham vilokya shayanat utthaye kinchichchanaihi nidra vyajam upagatasya sujiram nirvarnya patyurmukham visrabdham parichumbya jata pulakam alokya gandasthalim लज्जानम्रमुखी प्रियेण हसता बालेन चिरं चुम्बिता बाला चिरं चुम्बिता दिस् इस् देर् इन् काव्यप्रकाश एस् एन् एक्साम्पल् फार् शृङ्गारं सो बिफोर् विप्रलम्बशृङ्गारं हि फार् सम्भोगशृङ्गारं हि विल् गिव् दिस् इस् एन् एक्साम्पल् वेर् द नायिका इस् अ मुग्धा नायिका एण्ड् शी इस् अ नववधू शी इस् जस्ट् मेरिड् शी हेस् स्पेण्ट् द नैट् वित् हर् हस्बेण्ड् एण्ड् द मार्निङ्ग् the husband is first, maybe the first day or you know something like that you can say. So he is sleeping or he has just probably woken up, but she first wakes up. Shunyam vasagriham vilokya, she's extremely shy, she does not know how to approach and directly convey her wishes or anything of that sort, be very brave to her pati. So she finds a time when things are very calm and quiet in the place, in the vasagriham. Vasagriham is the bedroom. So shunyam vasagriham vilokya. Probably her friends were all, you know, teasing her as they were talking to her, and then these things happen. So she, maybe it is morning and suddenly one of the paricharika or the sakhi might suddenly come into that room. So she wants to ensure that there is nobody around, so that she can look at him visrabdham, without any fear or without any you can feel a little bit self-conscious, right, if people are there. So she does not want to feel so conscious, so she's looking around to see if the place is empty. Shunyam vasagriham vilokya, she sees that the vasagriham, the bedroom, is very empty. Shayanat utthaya, she gets up from her bed but is not out of it. Slowly she just rises her upper half, like she just gets up and sits on the bed. Shayanat utthaya kinchit shanaihi patyuhu mukham nirvarnya kinchit shanaihi shayanat utthaya, put that with this. So shanaihi, slowly she wakes up from her bed. She does not want to wake him up, her pati. And then she looks at his face. Patyur mukham nirvarnya, nirvarnya natu alokya, not just looking at him, okay, he is sleeping, and then she kisses him. That is not the idea here. So patyur mukham nirvarnya, she looks to check whether he is pretending to sleep or really he is asleep. But how is that patyuhu mukham, pati, how is he? Nidra vyajam upagataha saha patihi. So nidra vyajam upagatasya patyuhu mukham, he is pretending to sleep. And suchiram nirvarnya, she waits for a long time and looks at his face to check if there are any indications. Now she is convinced that he is sleeping. Okay. So Visrabdham Parichumbya. She did not have any opportunity to take the first step yesterday. So now she takes the step and Visrabdham, fearlessly, she kisses him. Parichumbya. Then what happens? He is awake. So if you're awake, your body naturally is, your mind is connected with the body and you, your body will react to that. So Jatapulakam Gandasthalim Alokya. Gandasthali. His cheeks where she had kissed, that pulakankitam, romancham happens. She looks at it. Then she knows that he is only pretending to sleep. So Gandasthalim Alokya Lajja Namramukhi Bala. She becomes very shy the moment she realizes that he has tricked her. She looks down with her, lowers her face in shyness. Lajja Namramukhi Bala Hasata Priyena. The pati is laughing. The beloved laughs at her because she is immediately, she feels shy and lowers her face. So he laughs at her and Chiram Chumbita, he reciprocates and kisses her. Now, this is a very beautiful shlokam. There is Asamlakshikramadhvani. You have the Uddipana Vibhavam, which is Shunyam Vasagriham. Alambana Vibhavam is Priyena, Priyaha Saha, Patihi Api, Esha Api Bala Navavadhuhu. So there is the Alambana Vibhavam there. Uddipana Vibhavam, it is an empty place and everything. So Kinchit Shanaihi Uthaya and all that are Anubhava. Lajja Namramukhi, Jata Pulaka, these are all your Vibhichari Bhavas. You get your Shungara Rasam. So Sambhoga Shungaraha Vyajyate Atra. So it's a beautiful example of Asamlakshikramadhvani. The same idea, the moment I've read this shlokam many times and I always feel it is a very beautiful shlokam. Is there anything that can be made more beautiful or anything else can contribute to this beauty? If you read the other shlokam, then you'll know. Nidra kaita vinaha priyasya vadane vinyasya vaktram vaduhu bodhatrasa nirutta chumpana rasapi avoga lolam sthita vailakshyat vimukhi bhavediti punaha tasyapi anarambinaha sakanksha pratipatti nama hridayam vyatam tu parambrate. Such a wonderful shlokam. See, the anticipation is much more than the action itself. The anticipation gives you that rasa anubhuti is much more in that akanksha. Yadi akanksha vartate, then the beauty is more. Chamatkara atishayaha vartate tatra. So nidra kaitavinaha priyasya vadane. Priyaha nidra kaitavina nidra vyajam ubhagatasya. It is very similar to the same shloka. It doesn't describe the uddipana vibhavam of shunyam vasagriham and all that. It is just, she looks at her beloved's face, lover's face, priyasya vadane, sva vaktram vaduhu, vaduhu itself says that she is a navavadhu, she's just married, she's a girl who has just experienced that love. So vadhuhu priyasya vadane, she places her vaktram, her own vaktram vinyasya, she places it on her nidra kaita vinaha priyasya vadane, on the beloved who is under the pretext of sleeping, right? Nidra kaita vinaha. Then she's hesitating. Abhogalolam sthita. Abhogalolam. Abhoga, she wants to enjoy. At the same time, she is also afraid. Bodhatrasa. She is afraid of waking him up. So bodhanata, bodhanena trasa. So suppose he wakes up, what do I do? So tadrisha bhayam vartate. So bodhatrasa tena niruddha chumbana rasapi. She has just stopped herself from kissing him. She's just placed her face on his face and then she's afraid to wake him up. So she has stopped that. Kintu abhoga lolam sthita. She's deciding what to do. Now, do I remove my face or do I just keep it there or do I proceed and kiss? What do I do? Abhoga lolam sthita. She's in a dilemma. She doesn't know what to do. She hesitates a little bit. What is he doing now? The pati, वैलक्ष्यात् विमुखी भवेत् इति पुनः तस्यापि अनारम्भिणः. हि आल्सो डस् नाट् स्टार्ट्, हि आल्सो डस् नाट् टर्न् हिस् फेस् एण्ड् यु नो रेसिप्रोकेट्. हि फील्स् देट् यु नो वैलक्ष्यात्, वैलक्ष्यम् अत्र लज्जा, लज्जाकारणात् सा प्रायः विमुखी भवेत् इति सो अपि अनारम्भिणः अनारम्भी तिष्ठति. हि डस् नाट् स्टार्ट्, चुम्बन आरम्भं न करोति. साकाङ्क्षप्रतिपत्ति नाम हृदयम्, उभयोरपि हृदयम् अत्र कथमस्ति, साकाङ्क्षप्रतिपत्ति. दे आर् एक्स्पेक्टिङ्ग् इन् दट् मोमेण्ट्, बोत् हार्ट्स् आर् इन् अ स्टेट् आफ् आण्टिसिपेशन्. एट् दट् पायिण्ट् यातं तु पारं रतेः, रतेः पारं यातं हृदयं. हृदयेन यु केन् हाव् बोत् ऐदर् द पासिव् वाय्स् आर् दि आक्टिव् वाय्स्. यु केन् से हृदयेन यातम् एण्ड् हृदयं यातम् आल्सो इस् works. So hridayam tu atra ratehe param yatam, it just reached the peak of love at that point because of that anticipation. It's more it's a beautiful, because in the second one there is a restriction to that love, right? So chumbanam sampannam iti tatraiva parimitatvam means there is a it is limited to just that chumbanam. Whereas in this shloka, in Nidra Kaitavinaha, Yatam tu Param Ratehe, it gives you the Shringara Parangatattvam is much more beautiful than just restricting it. Aparimitattvam. In a very similar manner, you know, there are many stories about Kalidasa and Bhavabhuti. In one of those, it's a very nice story, whether it actually happened or not is not relevant. There is one shloka in Uttaramacharitam, kimapi kimapi mandam mandam asakti yogat. Rama and Sita are sitting on the banks of Ganga, so they're reminiscing actually after all Ravana Yuddham and all has happened. It is Uttararamacharitam, right? So after the Ravana Yuddham has happened and they're in the palace, Sita is pregnant with Lava and Kusha. The scene starts with the both of them after Pattabhishekam and everything. So then you need to give the flashback, right? So Lakshmana comes with a mural of Rama's Charitam. So he says, this is a painting. Look at how he has drawn it beautifully, drawn your story very beautifully. And there is a scene where during the Vanavasam, Sita and Rama are sitting on the banks of Ganga, and in the night they've been talking. They describe how they spent their moments. Kimapi kimapi mandam mandam asakti yogat. We both were sitting together, and kimapi kimapi, it is not relevant at all, something or the other we were talking. And how were we talking? Mandam, very slowly, very softly. Why? Because we needn't shout to each other, very close to each other. So that proximity, asakti yogat, the proximity he describes in the next line, aviralita kapolam jalpator akramena. Aviralita kapolam, kapolam to aviralitam, there is no space between our cheeks, we were so close, asakti yogat, and jalpatoho akramena, we were also continuously saying something or the other. I ask a question, she didn't reply to that question, she was probably answering to something else or saying some other statement, but it did not matter to us at all at that point. Jalpator akramena kimapi kimapi, we were continuously talking something or the other softly because we were sitting close together. And then ashitila parirambha vyaprita ekaika doshnaha, we had embraced ourselves as we were sitting, you know. Ashithila, shithilam is just like that, you're putting your hand like that. It was not like that. Ashithilam, we were hugging each other tightly. Avidita gatayama ratri revam vyaramsit. So there is a difference. Ratri revam vyaramsit, that's how it should be, where the story goes that Kalidasa says chunnam adhikam, that anuswara is too much, you should not put that anuswara there. So if we had just said ratrihi evam vyaramsit, the night, avidita gata yama, we did not know the different yama, the different partitions of the night, and it just went in this manner, then it becomes tamila chappanu peduthumbo, there is no rasam there. If it is, whereas if it is ratri revam vyaramsit, asmakam Rati Athava, you know, that the conversation that we had did not stop. So our love did not stop with the night. Only the night went away. See, these are all a poet gives a new color, a new flavor to the same Shringaram. You know, and we keep saying every kavyam in Sanskritam is only Shringaram. You know, how many different there can be? Only Shringaram is okay. Why should we have to read it? No, the way a poet expresses it, that gives that apurvam to that shlokam or to that idea. There is an idea which has a beauty to it. Some small thing would just take that shlokam from being a very ordinary dhvani shloka to an extremely beautiful dhvani shloka. That is what happened here. Priya priyena hasata balena chi, bala chiram chumbita just limits it to only that. Whereas when you say sakanksha pratipatti hrudayam yatam tu param ratehe ratehe param yatam ityukte, you it is left to the imagination of the author, imagination of the connoisseur, the rasika. Rasika can think that is endless. Tatra. Whereas here, I am asking you to think only of that chumbaram. Whereas here, in the other shlokam, sakanksha pratipati, there is an anticipation. You don't know what happened, how they both. You can imagine so many scenes beyond what is being described here. That is how it becomes new. Yathava, this one is samlakshya kramadvani. तरङ्गभ्रूभङ्ग इत्यादि श्लोकस्य नानाभङ्गि भ्रमद्भ्रूः इत्यादि श्लोकापेक्षया अन्यत्वम्. सो नानाभङ्गि भ्रमत् भ्रूः भ्रूः वन् हू हेज़् दि ऐब्रो विच इस् भ्रमत् विच इस् मूविङ्ग् वित् डिफरेण्ट् भङ्गि डिफरेण्ट् एक्शन्स् आर् डिफरेण्ट् इन् देर् आर् मेनी ब्यूटिफुल् एक्शन्स् दट् द ऐब्रोस् आर् मेकिङ्ग्. So this is a shlokam which there is no source. We don't know the full shlokam. Neither does Abhinav Gupta write it, nor any other commentator has not given the entire shlokam for us to understand how it is not as good as Tarangabhrubhanga. Tarangabhrubhanga is in Vikramorushiyam. Tarangabhrubhangaha Kshupita. We have seen the shloka before, I think. Nadi rupeṇa iyam dhruvam asahana sa parinata. This is a more beautiful shlokam when compared to Nanabhangi Brahmadbruhu. Since we don't have that original shlokam, we can just skip to the next one. But I'll just explain this briefly. Tarangabhrubhanga Kshubhita Vihaga Shreni. He is looking at a nadi and he is reminded of Urvashi. Pururvas is reminded of Urvashi. He describes each and every action of the nadi and compares it. He remembers Urvashi in those actions. Tarangaha Eva Brubangaha. The ripples in the river is like her eyebrows. Brubangaha Kshubhita Vihaga Shreni Rashanaha. Kshubhita Vihaga. There is a kolaharam of the birds there. The birds are all chattering around, or what is some word? Okay. Kshubhita Vihagaha. The birds are chirping. So that is like the Shreni Rashana. It's like the Udyanam. Hip chain. Vikarshanti Phenam Vasanamiva Sambrambha Shitilam. So as she is moving, when a woman is, she's angry, when a lady is angry, and she just, you know, as she is going, the pallu or some part of the vasanam, the vastram, will just be falling, and sambrambha shithilam, because of the agitation, it will be loose and it will be falling, and that vikarshanti, you'll keep doing this and going, right? When someone walks off in anger, you will just pull up your sari and hold it in your hand and do it. So tadrisham iva atra phenam vikarshanti nadi. What she does is there is a foam as it comes to the shore. There is a foam phenam. She keeps pulling it towards her, like how a lady pulls the cloth which is loose because of the agitation. So vikarshanti phenam vasanamiva sambrambha shitilam यथाविधं याति स्खलितम् अभिसन्धाय बहुशः. स्खलितं यथाविधं स्खलितम् एस् इफ् शी इस् स्खलितं मीन्स् सो वेन् अ नदी फ्लोस् देर् आर् मेनी राक्स् एण्ड् स्माल् राक्स् आर् बिग् राक्स् इट् विल् जस्ट् स्लिप् ओवर् राक्स् एण्ड् कीप् मूविङ्ग्. हियर् आल्सो शी आल्सो बिकास् आफ् दि एङ्गर् इट् इस् एस् इफ् Urvashi is slipping and running as if she has been hit. Yatha vidham, as if she has been hurt. So when you're hurt in your leg, you will skip and go. Your walk will not be smooth enough. So nadi rupena iyam asahana asahana kopayukta esha sa nadi rupena parinata dhruvam. I think she has definitely become a nadi here. So this is much more beautiful. Probably he has just described nana bangi brahmat bruhu adha shreni rachana chanchat shreni rachana vasanam akarshanti, something like that, which is describing a girl or a lady who is in anger and moving away from the nayaka. Okay, this is for samlakshya. Now arthanam ananti, he starts with the karika and then continues to say about how artha visheshas can also be, and he gives examples for shabda shakti udbhavam, artha shakti udbhavam and all that. So generally he gave some examples, and now in for he gave avivakshita vachyatvani for tiraskrita atyanta tiraskritam and idilya arthantra sankramitam were the examples. Now this is samlakshikramadhvani for nidra kaita vinaha. Then for in the samlakshikrama vyangyam, that taranga brumanga is actually samlakshikrama vyangyam, but he, from here he will give a series of examples of samlakshikramadhvani because of the artham, how the meaning can also give you a new idea. So yuktya anaya, in this manner yuktya anaya anusartavyo rasadihi bahuvistaraha mitopi anantatam praptaha kavya margo yatashraya. Kavya margaha is based on rasa, but that rasa mitaha api, even though rasam is just how do I say, mitaha means it is very limited, even though it is kavya margam is limited, it is based on rasa, bhava, tadabhasa, etc. And differences of vibhava, anubhava. In fourth ullasa of Kavya Prakasham, you will find how based on the vibhava, anubhava, the naika, nayaka, and then the uddipana vibhavam can be different. Based on that, there are so many different ways in which a poet can contribute to creativity or newness to a poetry. So yuktya anaya anusartavyaha, in this manner, if a poet follows all these things in this manner, rasadihi bahuvistaraha, bahuvistaraha rasadihi, rasam etc. Rasa rasadihi adipadena, we have to take bhava, tadabhasa, tadprashamana, all of these types are also contributing to that margam, kavi margaha, kavya margaha, which is bahuvistaraha. The innumerable varieties of rasas contribute to the kavya marga being anantam. It is infinite, even though it is limited. So what does that mean? Mito api kavya margaha anantatam praptaha yat ashrayat. So take the first line as separate. Anaya yuktya, with the, in this manner. So navatvam, however I have shown that navatvam before, anaya yuktya, rasad bahu vistaraha rasadihi, rasa bhava etc., which is bahu vistaraha, which has innumerable varieties, anusartavyaha, it has to be followed. So this rasa etc. has to be followed in this manner. That is, we have to try to infuse some newness to each poetry. Yad ashrayat, yasya rasasya ashrayat, adava rasadehe ashrayat, because of the kavya margam being based upon these rasas. Rasa is the pradhanam here, right? Mitaha api, mitaha means, what are the different kavyams you have? Gadhyam, padhyam, champu. In the gadhyam, you will have some akhyayika, katha, etc. Padhyam, you have khandakavyam, lagukavyam, mahakavyam. Then maybe stotra literature, stuti literature, didactic poems, etc. And then in champu, you have, there is just one variety. Then natakam. this margam is just very less. Even natakam, you have dasha main types of natakam, and then you have 24 or something upanatikas are there. Upanatak. This is just a very limited section, and there are so many rules that Dasharupakara gives, Natyashastrakara gives, making it very limited with the strong outer boundaries within which you have to try to give creativity. It is not without any rules, right? So you have rules also. Mitaha api anantatam praptaha katham rasadeerashrayateva anantatam praptaha. It becomes infinite because of the, it becomes many because of the support of rasam. So the vritti is just an explanatory of that karika. So bahuvistaraha ayam rasa bhava tadabhasa tat prashamana lakshanaha margaha yathasvam vibhava anubhava prabheda kalanaya yathasvam means as is supportive of itself, yatha yogyam. स्वस्य इव रसस्य यथा योग्यं वर्तते तादृश विभाव अनुभाव प्रभेद योजनया. ओके, सो यथा स्वं विभाव अनुभाव प्रभेद कलनया यथोक्तं प्राक् इत्युक्ते अनुसर्तव्यः, प्रागुक्तरीत्या अनुसर्तव्यः. यदाश्रयात् यस्य रसादेः आश्रयात् अयं काव्यमार्गः, बै द सपोर्ट् आफ् सच् रस एक्सेट्रा, दिस् काव्यमार्गं पुरातनैः कविभिः सहस्रसङ्ख्यैः असङ्ख्यैः वा बहुप्रकारं क्षुण्णत्वात् इट् इस् बीन् ट्रोडन् गतत्वात् अनुसृतत्वात् बहुप्रकारम् अनुसृतम्. अयं काव्यमार्गः पुरातनैः कविभिः सहस्रसङ्ख्यैः, थौसण्ड्स् आफ् ओल्डर् पोयेट्स्, and asankhyaihi or innumerable poets who cannot be counted, bahuprakaram in many different ways, even though this kavyamargam has been undertaken by many people. Mitaha api, it is still measured and limited, yet anantatam eti katham rasashrayat. Okay, so rasabhavadinam hi pratyekam vibhava anubhava vyavichari samashrayat aparimitattvam. It is limitless because you in Shringara Rasam you can take based on the Nayaka is a Divya Nayaka, Shringara Rasa Pradhanam, and then for the Divya Nayaka you can have an Adivya Nayika, or you can have a Madhya Nayika, Mugdha Nayika, Proudha Nayika. So many different varieties, and then the scene can be different. It can be a forest, or it can be a grama, it can be Rajakatha, or it can be in Swargam. So that also depends. Anubhava, there can be different ways of expressing the love. The Vyabhichari Bhavas are some 33 in number. Even if you have 25 Vyabhichari Bhavas, all 25 need not be used for Shringara Rasam. So it depends on what Rasa Pradhanam it is. So iti aparimitattvam, it is endless. Teshamcha ekaika prabheda apekshaya api tavate, even if you take just one type from each, say if you have a Shringa, in Shringara Rasam you take only Veera Rasam, and then for that Veera Rasam you have, there are four different types of Dhirodhata, Dhirodhatta, what Dhirodhudhata is there, Dhirodhatta is there can be a combination of that. Ekaikamapi prabheda apekshaya tavat jagadvrittam upanibadhyamanam sukavibhihi तद् इच्छावशात् अन्यथा स्थितमपि अन्यथैव विवर्तते. सो हौएवर् संसारव्यवहारं, बिकास् आफ् द वे द वर्ल्ड् वर्क्स्, ही केन् कम्प्लीट्लि तद् इच्छावशात् सुखविभिः वाट् एवर् ही फील्स् लैक् जगद्वृत्तम् उपनिबध्यमानम्. ही इस् ओन्ली यूसिङ्ग् द स्टोरी दट् इस् देर् इन् दिस् वर्ल्ड्. जगद्वृत्तं जगत् कथा एव उपनिबध्यमानं कथ्यमानमपि सुखविभिः तदिच्छावशात् वाट् एवर् द पोयट् वाण्ट्स् टु कन्वे अकार्डिङ्ग् टु हिस् विश् अन्यथा स्थितमपि. वाट् एवर् ही सीस् इन् द वर्ल्ड् केन् आल्सो बि टेकन् अन्यथा विवर्तते. ही केन् टर्न् इट् इन् टु समथिङ्ग् डिफरेण्ट् आल्सो इन् द in his poetry. Pratipaditam cha yetat chitra vichara avasare. That chitrakavyam is bhavan achetananapi chetanavat chetanan achetanavat vyavaharayati yateshtam sukavihi kavye swatantrataya. This is there in Tritiyodyotam where he talks about chitrakavyam. There he says bhavan achetanana bhavan api chetanavat vyavaharaha kartum shakyate kavina. Tathaiva चेतनान् अपि अचेतनवत् व्यवहारं कर्तुं शक्यते व्यवहारयितुं शक्यते कविना. सो ही केन् मेक् देम् पर्फार्म् ही केन् मेक् कान्शियन्स् बीङ्ग् पर्फार्म् लैक् एन् इद् जडवस्तु अण्ड् ए जडवस्तु लैक् बीङ्ग् वित् कान्शियस् कान्शियन्स् इट् केन् बि पासिबल् एनिथिङ्ग् केन् बि पासिबल् इन् द पोयट्स् वर्ल्ड्. गाथा च अत्र कृता एव महाकविना. सम् पोयट् इस् गिवन् दिस् गाथा इट् इस् इन् प्राकृतम्. This is तथा स्थितानपि तथा संस्थितानिव हृदये या निवेशयति अर्थविशेषान् सा जयति विकटकविगोचरा वाणी. वाणी सा वाणी जयति. सरस्वती इस् आल्वेस् विक्टोरियस्. स्पीच् इस् आल्वेस् सर्वोत्कर्षेण वर्तते जयति इति. नाट् विक्टोरियस् मीन्स् शी जस्ट् विन्स् इन् अ बेटल्. ऐ आल्वेस् सेड् दट् सर्वोत्कर्षेण वर्तते इत्यर्थः जयति. सा वाणी जयति. कथम् अस्ति सा वाणी? विकटकविगोचरा. विकटकविगोचरा कविगोचरं द स्कोप् आफ् द पोयेट् विकटं विकटं विस्तृतं करोति एषा. सो वाणी विकटकविगोचरा एषा वाणी. स्पीच् अटेन्स् इन्क्रीसेस् बिकास् आफ् द कविवाणी. Normal speech, Neelakanta, who is the Neelakanta Dikshitar also says, no? Yaneva shabdan vayam alapamaha, yaneva cha arthan vayam ullikamaha. Whatever words we say and whatever words, artham we are trying to highlight. Taireva vinyasa vishesha bhavyaihi. Taireva vinyasa vishesha bhavyai sammohayante kavayo jaganti. The poets sammohayante, they totally delude the whole world, you know, with the words that they are, the vinyasa vishesha gaurehi, by the way they arrange the words, they are able to sammohayante. So very similar to that. Atatastitan tatha na santi tathavi tatha santi iva asmakam hrudaye bhavayanti. They try to give us that impression that it is like that. Maybe, you know, slowly as you start reading, you will think that, okay, Kirti is white, Apakirti is black. That idea keeps on reinforcing, but we have to remain strong also sometimes and not be deluded by all that, right? And the moment spring comes, you feel the love is in the air. But it's mostly because the poet has described it like that. We do feel happiness, but not necessarily that, you know, love should be there in the air. But his influence, the poet's influence is so much. And if we do have that sahrudayatvam, we get influenced by it. Atatasthitanapi. तथास्थितानिव हृदये या निवेशयति. या वाणी अस्माकं हृदये अथवा रसिकानां हृदये एवं निवेशयति. चेतनान् अचेतनैव अचेतनान् चेतनैव अर्थविशेषान् सा जयति. नौ अर्थविशेषाणाम् आनन्त्यमपि दर्शयति. तदित्थं रसभावादि आश्रयेण काव्यार्थानाम् आनन्त्यं सुप्रतिपादितम्. नौ रसभावादि आश्रयेण we have explained that etadeva upapadayitum uchyate. He just gives a karika drishtapurva api hi arthaah yaneva shabdan vayamalapama. It's I like the way Neelakanta Dikshita has given it in a for us to use it like this. Drishtapurva api hi arthaah kavye rasaparigrahat sarve navaiva abhanti madhumasa ivadrumaah. Perfect example of the explanation of that apurvatvam. दृष्टपूर्वाः हि अर्थाः. वाट् एवर् अर्थं वाट् एवर् मीनिङ्ग् दट् वी हेव् सीन् बिफोर् काव्ये रसपरिग्रहात् द काव्यं यूसस् इट् इन् अ वेरि रसपूर्ण मेनर् इन्फ्यूसस् रसम् इन् इट् एण्ड् देन् सर्वे अर्थाः नवाः इव आभान्ति. इट् सीम्स् लैक् न्यू फार् अस् जस्ट् लैक् मधुमासे द्रुमाः इव. The same tree we will be seeing every day outside, it will be barren during the winter season. Suddenly spring will come and there is so many flowers. Suddenly one day, you know, the tree outside is filled with lovely white and pink flowers. And then the leaves start coming out. You feel every year you see this. 6 years I've been here, and every year I see that transformation. And still, it is as if that tree has come alive. It seems more beautiful today. Every year, you go through that even in your mind during the spring season. So, Madhumase yatha dhrumaha navaha iva avanti. It is the same tree that is there outside for the past 6 years. But every spring season, you find that tree beautiful. It seems as if, oh, it's so nice. You have to make a mention of that. It seems new to us. That is what artham is in a kavya. It's the same only, but the way he expresses it is new, something different. The poet contributes something new to it. So for samlakshikrama, Shabda Shakti Udbhava, Artha Shakti Udbhava. He is going to give examples for each. How a Puratana shlokam is there, but there is a Navatvam in a poetry that is later. But sometimes, like in this shlokam, he makes a mistake. Someone has pointed out saying the second shlokam, Shesho Himagirihi Tvam, is actually Vamaha shloka, and Dharani Dharanaya Adhuna Tvam Shesha is Harshacharitam Bana. Both of them lived in similar times, or maybe one century this way, this way. Bana was Bana preceded Vamaha, I don't know. So it's all Anandavardhana wants to point out is if a new meaning is used, or a type of dvani can actually enhance the meaning that is already present. Tathahi vivakshitanyaparavachyasyaiva shabdashakti udbhava anuranana roopa vyangya prakara samashrayena navatvam. When we use that shabdashakti udbhava, then it becomes more beautiful. We look at the second one. So Shesho Himagiristvamcha Mahantaha Guravaha Sthiraha Yad Alanghita Maryadaha Chalantim Bibhratha Kshitim Shesha Himagirihi Tvamcha Kshitim Bibhratha Chalantim Kshitim Bibhratha. You, all three of you, Shesha, Adishesha, Himagirihi, Himalayas, Tvam, Hey Rajan, Tvam, Iti Trayaha Api Imam Kshitim Bhumim Bibhratha. All three of you are supporting, taking care of Rakshatha. All three of you are protecting this earth. There is another reading of Bibhrate. If you're interested, you can read the Diditi Vyakhyanam for this, about how the Atmanepadi cannot come. All three of them are protecting this earth, or bearing the weight of this earth for others and not for themselves. It is that they are actually only giving so much of torture for themselves. Why would anybody want to carry that bhumi on their head? He is doing it for the loka hitaya. So Shesha, that's why it has to be in Parasmaipadi and not Atmanepadi. So Shesha Himagirihi Tvamcha Iti Trayaha Abhi Mahantaha Guravaha Sthiraha. Now each one will apply in a different way, for because it is Shabda Shakti Udbhavam, Shlesha also should be there. But that is Shlishta Shabdaha, where there can be two, three meanings. If we take Mahantaha as indicating only for Shesha, or and Guravaha for Guruhu for Himagiri, and Sthira for Rajan, then the rest, by force of the word, it will apply to all three actually. It's a very nice shlokam only. It's not Shabda Shakti Udbhavam, but it's more like Shlesha here. Anyway, so Shesha, Adishesha is both Vipula Akaram, that is Mahana. Mahana, he has a big form. Himagiri also has a big form to look at. But for the Rajan, you don't say Nripaha. He is not fat or anything, but he is great. So Mahantaha Guravaha Bhuvara Sahatvata Gauravabritaha. Not heavy. Adishesha is not like heavy. That is not the point here, because they are capable of Bhubaram Sahanam. They can tolerate the Bhumi Bharam. They are great. गौरवम् खरिस्मा स्थिराः अचलत्वं हिमगिरिः तु अचलः इट् डजन्ट् मूव् फार् राजा एण्ड् शेष आदिशेष दृढप्रतिज्ञा दे डु नाट् स्वेर् स्वे अवे फ्रम् देर् प्रामिस् टु प्रोटेक्ट् दि अर्त् यत् आलङ्घितमर्यादाः दे डु नाट् मूव् अवे फ्रम् देर् मर्यादा बौण्ड्री and they protect this earth which is constantly moving chalantim kshitim it's a difficult task that they have on hand if you look at that harshacharita shlokam the gadyam portion dharani dharanaya aduna tvam sheshah you alone are left today tvam eva sheshah sheshah avashishtah asi you alone remain today to take care of this earth to bear the weight of the world dharani dharanaya aduna he harsha tvam eva sheshah avashishtah asi I think it is addressing harsha I'm not sure if it is someone else excuse me I don't know so dharani dharanaya aduna tvam eva sheshah that word shesha contextually means the king either harsha or someone who is responsible there I think it is harsha and you fix the prakaranam there and say sheshah ityukte avashishtah shabda shaktya because of the meaning other meaning of that word is adisheshah adisheshah iva tvamapi dharani dharanaya samarthah eva iti arthah vyajyate atra That is Shabda Shakti Uttam. It's more beautiful than the shlokam given. Yeah. Ityadishu satsu api. So when the shloka exists, Shesho himagirihi iti shlokasya sattve api, dharani dharanaya aduna tvam sheshaha ityadehe navatvam. That's how the anvayam goes for each and every example that he gives after this. Okay. 45, yeah. Wanted to finish all of these mudima therla papa tasyaiva artha shakti udbhava anuranana roopa vyangya samashrayena navatvam na tasyaiva artha shakti udbhavam we have seen this evam vadini devar show parshve piduratav mukhi leela kamala patrani ganayamasa parvati the shlokam we have seen before so let's look at an earlier shlokam ityadishu satsu api even though the shloka exists evam vadini devar show which is a newer shloka is more beautiful because of artha shakti udbhava dhvani in that because the earlier shlokam has not much the word itself is mentioned there vyavichari swashabda vachyatvam is there so krite varakathalape कुमार्यः पुलकोद्गमैः सूचयन्ति स्पृहाम् अन्तर्लज्जा अवनत मुखि अन्तर्लज्जया अवनत आननाः अन्तर्लज्जया अवनत आननाः कुमार्यः कृते वरकथालापे कृते वरकथालापे वरकथा आलापे वर ब्रैड्ग्रूम् कथा ए ए वेन् देर् इस् अ टाक् आफ् एनी न्यूस् अबौट् द ब्रैड्ग्रूम् वरः वरस्य कथायाः आलापः यदा प्रचलति सति आलापे प्रचलति सति वेन् दट् द टाक् आफ् अ ब्रैड्ग्रूम् हेपन्स् इमिडियट्लि द लेडीस् पुलको द गर्ल्स् युनो कुमार्यः पुलक उत्कमैः रोमाञ्चयुक्ताः स्वस्पृहां सूचयन्ति दे मे पुट् देर् हेड् डौन् अन्तर्लज्जया बिकास् आफ् दि लज्जा विदिन् देम् avanata ananaha they lower their faces in shyness even with even though they lower their faces in shyness spriham suchayanti pulakodgamaihi spriham suchayanti there is romancham in their body and they indicate their spriha interest even though they lower their face in shyness the interest is seen because of the pulaka udgamam romancham that is there in their body कृते वरकथालापे सति वेरि सिमिलर् टु दट् एवं वादिनि देवर्षो पितुरधोमुखि बट् इन् एवं वादिनि लज्जा इस् ओन्लि व्यज्यमानत्वं दट् इस् वै इट् इस् मोर् ब्यूटिफुल् बिकास् आफ् द लीलाकमलपत्राणि गणयामास पार्वती वेरस् इयर् लज्जा इस् मेन्शन्ड् इयर् स्पृहा अगेन् दि इण्ट्रेस्ट् एण्ड् औत्सुक्यम् इस् क्यूरियोसिटि इस् मेन्शन्ड् इयर् So there is less beauty when compared to Evam Madri. अर्थशक्ति उद्भव अनुरणन रूप व्यंग्यस्य कवि प्रौढोक्ति निर्मित शरीरत्वेन नवत्वम्. नाउ दिस इज फॉर कवि प्रौढोक्ति. वी सॉ द एग्जांपल ऑफ सज्जयति सुरभि मासो यथा सज्जयति. लेट्स लुक एट द अदर एज यूजुअल द सेकंड वन एंड देन गो टू दैट. सुरभि समये प्रवृत्ते सहसा प्रादुर्भवन्ति रमणीयाः राघवताम् उत्कलिकाः सहैव सहकार कलिकाभिः. देयर इज जस्ट सहोक्ति अलंकारम इन दिस. So, Surabhi Maase, Surabhi Samaye Pravritte Sati. When at the advent of spring, when it begins, Ramaniyaha Pradhur Bhavanti, Raghavatam Ramaniyaha Utkalikaha Pradhur Bhavanti. Utkalika is Autsukyam, Utkantha, Utkanthaha Pradhur Bhavanti, Raghavatam. Yoshitam, those ladies who are very passionate, as soon as spring season starts, their mind, there is a, in their hearts, there is a small, the longings begin to happen in their mind. Sweet longing. So, Ramaniyaha Utkalikaha, very beautiful longing. Edo un yarodiyavadu anubhavikkano nu avadi thonum. No, you want to enjoy that season with someone. That sort of a idea comes up in the minds of people who are extremely passionate. So, Raghavatam Yoshitam Manasi Ramaniyaha Utkalikaha Pradurbhavanti Kaihi Saha Sahakara Kalikabihi Sakabhi Saha. It's in Strilingam. So, even more beautiful. Along with Sahakara Kalika, along with the buds of mango buds, along with mango buds, the longings also sprout forth in the minds of the girls. This is nice. But it is only Sahokti Alankaraha. It is more of a... you're trying to say that it is Madana Udrekaha. It is a madana uddipakam, manmatha uddipakam asti tatra. The uddipakata eva atra vyajyate. That is okay. But it is more gunibhutam than a beautiful dhvani shlokam. So when you add the dhvani in sajjayati surabhi masaha, natavadarpayati yoti jana lakshyana. He does not, he has only readied the arrows. He has still not put it on the faces of the ladies. He has not shot his arrows to the ladies' faces. Abhinava sahakara mukana navavallava vatralana anangasya sharana. We've seen this before in second Udyotam. So he only readies it. He is still not natavad arpayati. He has not shot it on their faces. Even before that, it is very difficult to tolerate the season. What to say when spring is at its peak? So that idea of Arthashakti Udbhava Vyangyam, that idea is more beautiful than what we see in this shloka. And Arthashakti Udbhava, this one I think is not there in some reading. I want you to look at your Tirupati text and tell me whether this is there or not. Or does it go directly to the next one? Can you just check and tell me?
Yes, Sakka, just 1 minute.
Yeah. So this shloka is not there in your text, but the problem is the next shloka, Vanijaka Hasti Dantaha, that should be there, but that is more of a Swatasambhavi and not Kavinibaddha Vaktru Pravodokti. So for Kavinibaddha Vaktru Pravodokti, some of the manuscripts have mentioned these shlokas, so I will just explain that also. So this may or may not come. That doesn't matter. So Arthashakti Udbhava Anuranana Rupa Vyangyasya Kavinibaddha Vaktru Pravodokti Nishpinna Sharirathvena Navatvam. So the earlier shloka here is Udipvara Kacha Boga Yatha Yatha Stanaka Vardhante Bhalanam Tata Tata Labdha Vasaha Iva Manmataha Hridayam Avishati. So the lady, the girls, Bhalanam, उदित्वर कच आभोग स्तनकाः वर्धन्ते यथा यथा बालानां स्तनकाः वर्धन्ते. एज देयर ब्रेस्ट स्वेल आउट उदित्वर कच आभोगाः. द कच इज देयर हेयर which is abhoga, which is surrounding. So as their hair also grows, their stanaka, small breasts which are just budding, it also grows. Tata tata manmataha manmatha labdha avasaha eva, as if he has gotten a place now to stay. Hridayam avishati, he enters the hearts of these girls. This is an earlier shlokam where it just utpreksha is there. Manmataha labdha avasaha eva, as if he has gotten a place to stay. Manmatha, that is a sambhavana there, so it is utpreksha alankara. Another a better way with the kavi prodokti, kavinibaddha vaktra prodokti is sadara vitirna yavana hastalambam samunnamadbyam abhyuttanam evam namatasya dattam tavahastanabhyam. This also we have seen before. Etat gatarthe na paunaruktyam. Even though the artham is similar, as tarunyam enters a girl, when youth enters a girl, the changes that are there to her body, it is as if she is welcoming Manmatha, who is a guest. In this, it is more beautiful. Hasta avalambanam kritam iva yatha tarunyam sadara vitirna yavvana hasta avalambanam. So like a paricharika who extends her hand for the nayika to stand up, or a royal lady to stand up, in that manner it is as if the youth has extended its hand for her samunnamadbyam stanabhyam, for her stana to get up in to receive, to greet Manmatha. So that has a more beauty than the earlier shloka that we saw. Labdha avasa eva manmataha avishati. It becomes very limited. Manmatha enters the mind. There is no vyangyam as such there. Okay, the manmatha aveshaha is more, is not so chamatkaram as the utpreksha alankara, which is more beautiful. So it is like a gunibhutam. Whereas this one is a dhvani shloka. Yathava, this is actually a swatasambhavi shlokam. Very similar to Shikipitcha Karnapura. Vanijaka hasti dantaha kuto asmakam. This has been handled in third Udyota, which we have not studied till now. So I have taken the whole shloka here. Before that, we will look at Karini Vaidhavyakaraha and then go to Vanijaka, which is the earlier shloka. Evamadishu artheshu satsu api analidata. Alidam is touching. Analidam, it doesn't even touch. So analidata is where the beauty, there is more beauty in this. Aspristatvam, yes. Analidatvam means aspristatvam. The idea has not been touched before. So Karini Vaidhavyakaraha Mama Putraha Eka Kanda Vinipati Hatasnushaya Tatha Kritaha Yata Kanda Karandakam Vahati. It's a nice shlokam, not to say anything about it. Mama Putraha, mother-in-law, is talking about her son. And so a mother is talking about her son. So Mama Putraha, my son, Karini Vaidavyakaraha. He was capable of bringing widowhood to an entire host of elephants. So he killed the elephant, what is that, a low tusker, you know, yuthapatihi. Yuthapatimapi hatva karininam vaidhavyakaraha saha. He had made all the female elephants vidavaha, widows, by killing a yuthapati also. With what? Eka kanda vinipati, with just one arrow. Kandam is sharaha. With just one arrow, Vinipati, by shooting just one arrow, my son had made an entire host of elephants widows. Now what happened? Mama snushaya, hata snushaya, hata ityukte papa, the para fauna, I like that word in Tamil. It is more of where the mother-in-law doesn't like it that son is always constantly spending, or the mother doesn't like it that her son is constantly spending time with the girl who is married. So this, my daughter-in-law, you know what has been done by this daughter-in-law, that he is constantly carrying a basket full of arrows now. Karan, kanda karandakam, he used to have only one arrow, and with that one arrow he used to kill the tusker, and he had achieved so much. Now he just roams around with so many arrows in one basket. With a, he is not like a Veera. She has done something to him, some magic he has, she has done. The beauty is Kanda Karandakam. He doesn't use Kanda Thuniram. Karandakam is a basket, Thuniram is a quiver. He just collects all the arrows that he has and takes it in a hand. That's all. He doesn't even use it in his quiver. So evamadishu arteshu satsu. Then what is the other shlokam? It is about how merchant comes and asks in the house, do you have any, you know, ivory, or do you have any tiger skin for selling? So the merchant is coming to the house and asking. So the mother replies saying, hey vanijaka, hastidantaha kuto asmakam vyagrakrittayaha cha yaval lulita alaka mukhi grihe parishvakkate snusha. This girl is roaming around in this house. Grihe parishvakkate. She's just, you know, strutting around, you should say. Grihe parishvakkate. Lulita alaka mukhi. Her face is covered with alakam. Alakam is chikuram. All the corner, you know, locks of hair are lulitam. It is constant. She is not prasadhanam na kritam. She's not tied her hair well. So it is lulita alaka mukhi esha snusha yavat parishvakkate tavat asmakam haste kutaha hastidantaha. How will we have ivory and vyagra krittayaha vyagra charma? We will not have tiger skins or ivory, where this fellow won't even go out and hunt for us to have ivory. He is constantly with that. So that is even more beautiful. And the visheshanam of Lulita Alaka Mukhi contributes a beauty to it. It's a vyanjakam. That is actually a padaprakashyata. Not a Vakya Prakashita, but a Pada Prakashita. Vakya Prakashita is Shikivichakarnapura. There the entire Vakyam will give you the Vengyam. Here only that Lulita Alaka Mukhi suggests that Rati, Sambhogam. She has no time to even, you know, decorate herself or comb her hair and all that. Ityadi Gatha Arthasya Emamadishu Artheshu Satsu Api Analidata Yaval Lulita Alaka Mukhi Ityarthasya Analidata Asprishtatvam. So it is not, that meaning has not been touched before by anybody, and when this poet has said it in such a beautiful manner, it is nice. So with this then he concludes it with another karika. So with this, arthanam anantyam is done. We will look at the next karika and the conclusion of this. He just says one line, yatha vyangya beda samashrayena dvanehe kavyarthanam namattam upadyate tadrusha vyanjaka bedena. Now he showed only with the vyangyatvam till now, and then he will show with vyanjaka bedam. Vyangya Bedam and Vyanjaka Bedam. So from the suggestion based of difference or a newness that has been brought because of the difference in the suggestion, those are the examples that we saw till now. Next, he will show the difference based on the Vyanjaka Pada or Vyanjaka Vakyam. Depends on what becomes the, what is used as the suggesting factor. Okay.